My name is Jason Greer, labor relations expert and former board agent with the National Labor Relations Board. When labor unions are seeking to launch union organizing campaigns, one of their main sales to potential employees is the idea that if you join the union and you don't like us, then decertify us after 1 year and we'll gladly go away. To an employee that has never had any experience with unions, this sounds like a great deal. What they don't know is that the decertification process is more difficult than they are led to believe. In order for any union in America to seek representation of a group of employees, they must get at least 30% of the employees to sign union authorization cards. Once this is done, then they have the right to file a petition for a secret ballot union election with the National Labor Relations Board. Should the union organization win the union election, then for one calendar year, they officially represent the employees. After that year is over, the employees have the right to file a decertification petition, which really means we don't want to be part of the union. But in order to do this, the employees have to collect a petition with the names of at least 30% of the employees, and then it becomes their responsibility to wage a campaign against the union because management cannot interfere. What generally happens is that the person or the people behind the decertification petition are targeted and harassed by union organizers. They are called such names as sellouts and scabs. This decertification process can be so difficult for people that many end up dropping the decertification petition due to the stress and the exile they feel from their coworkers, friends, and even family. In short, there's no such thing as give us 1 year. If you join a union, in many cases, you're stuck.